stab. Come on, Penny, you can do it. Just the resolution of the stream went down, so it looked like you were smaller.
Oh, okay. Oops. Oh, I messed that up. there goes that idea.
Dash. This goat has eyes. It can goat see.
Oh! You have to go there.
I guess I did.
We don't need the game to die on us again, Dave.
The game's like, I'm disgusted with these two. Called a goatee because it kind of looks like the scruffy beard that goats have.
Possibly. I feel like I'm just running in circles on this level.
Can't jump, can it?
Nope.
Although, and this sounds crazy, but the area you ran the mouse around to hit that button, would you be able to teleport with it when you were right on the edge and then fall down a bit below?
No, because I don't have the magic hat. Magic hat only works for the level that you're on. Haha.
Well, you're kinda getting there. By kinda, I mean you'll probably solve this by the time I talk.
See ya, mouse. I didn't like that mouse anyways. Oh, that was beautiful.
Oh dear. Sorry, that laugh was probably more evil than I intended.
Oh, this is one of those levels where you know what you need to do, but that doesn't make it any easier.
Yeah. It's all in the execution.
There's lots of executing, that's for sure.
Well, we were talking about Pokemon before.
Oh, yeah. Execute.
Yep. When's the weirder Pokemon?
It makes its comeback in the new game.
I think one of my favorites is Farfetch'd, just because it's a duck with a spring on it.
Which also makes a comeback.
I think the problem is you're hitting the buttons a little too late.
Yep. You know, I think Farfetch'd just proves that Pokemon were meant to be eaten. I mean, he comes with his seasoning right with him.
Duck is so delicious.
Duck is good. I haven't had it in a long time, though.
We've got so many great Asian restaurants around here. But duck is expensive. And it's about lunchtime, so I should stop talking about food.
Ow! Now, leaving the mouse on the blue block isn't going to help, because it will push one down as well as one up.
Is that good fortune about eating duck?
All right. Let's see here. There we go. Bye, mouse. I didn't like you anyways.
Let's give Pammy a big round of applause. Woo!
A bottomless pit. Huh.
What if I can go buy duck and put it up for lunch? I'm seriously considering this now.
I'm more trying to... This level's already making me...
Oh. I forgot you could double jump.
Yep. Good thing, too.
You know, you talk about how the double jump's one of your favorite. I think wall jump is one of my favorite things in platforms.
I love wall jumps depending on the game. Like... Sheep. Oh, sheep! I love double jumps when it's like, Ninja Gaiden, I love double jumps on that.
You mean wall jumps?
Yeah, wall jumps. Sorry. I kind of like it in Metroid, but I...
Ooh, that was really difficult. Like, you had to be perfect with those.
Right. The one game I hate wall jumps the most... I like wall jumps on Mario games, too. That's one thing they've added in the recent Mario games I like. The game that I hate the wall jump in the most, though, has to be the NES Strider.
Huh.
The timing on the NES version of Strider for a wall jump is so frustrating.
Yeah, I like when it's just really effortless. Like, Super Meat Boy has brilliant ones. Because, like, in Mario 64, he scrapes down the wall. So, yeah, all the time in the world.
Yeah, Super Meat Boy is a great game. I should stream that at some point.
Yeah, I got up to Dr. Fetus, but I never beat him.
I haven't played it all the way through. I did play quite a bit of it, though. That is a really great game. Soundtrack's really good on it, too.
Yep. Oh. This one's tricky.
Yeah. It's quite the level, for lack of better words. Oh.
Hmm.
Yes. See, this is that good type of challenge though, where it's like, it's despite the fact that it's hard, I don't feel like I want to, you know, break something.
And like, when you fail, you know it's your fault?
Yeah. And that way, whenever I succeed, I feel like, you know, I've made a major accomplishment, too. I got another game that I was...
Well done.
Let's see. I got another game. Somehow, I don't think that was how I was supposed to pass the level, but...
No.
I'm not gonna complain.
Usually challenges ahead, remember to work together. You only be more powerful than Magic Goat. It's a Magic Goat with a friend.
With a mouse friend. But I'm not using a mouse for this. I'm using a controller. Let's see. I got another game on Steam recently. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. I think it's like Ares Action or something like that. But I'm thinking of streaming that one, but that one might make me punch my laptop. Because...
You don't want that.
Because, yeah, I played it briefly, and it's that type of... unpredictable challenge that it just infuriates you.
I was getting pretty mad last night in those last levels in Rayman Origins. Those were psychotic.
See, I don't even think I got through the first level of Action, and I already died like 17 times. So, yeah, there's no way to tell any of the stuff that's going to happen. It's purposely there just to pretty much drive you insane.
Just sounds like bad game design.
I think it's someone who had that kind of, what do you call it? Oh, fuck. Well, that happened fast. What is it? I want to save the guy kind of mentality.
Oh, yeah.
Or I want to be the guy mentality when they made the game. Because that's exact kind of challenge it has.
It's basically a fuck you game.
Pretty much. Oh my, this level is not even giving me a chance to react to anything. Oh boy.
Rote memorization.
I don't think any of these things I've touched have helped me. Okay.
So don't hit the skulls?
Seems to be the philosophy here, but that's kind of easier said than done.
Nope.
I may be a coward, but I'm a greedy little coward. Oh my goodness. This level's insane.
And it's only number one.
Insane in the brain.
Insane in the brain. Insane, got no brain. I don't know if I'll have any left after this. Man. I knew that wasn't gonna work, but I decided to try it anyways. Right.
Yeah, wow.
Where's that Mario style ground pound when I need one?
Another game.
I always thought ground pound sounded kind of perverse.
Do you have to turn the fire on?
Yes, because they clear out those blocks.
Maybe you need to come back the way you came instead of just trying to drop. Or jump to the middle platform to avoid the top fireball. Double jump.
Let's see.
No, Fry, you can't fall fast enough.
You know what's a game that I've heard a lot of people talk about that I've actually not played yet? I don't own it on Steam as of yet. I have not played Spelunky.
Ah, yes. I reviewed the port of Everyday Spelunker on iOS a few weeks ago. It's the port of the 1983 Commodore 64 game, which kind of Spelunky took a lot of its inspiration from. It kind of shows you how far Spelunky's come.
See, I think that game was released on Nintendo also, because...
Yeah, it was just called Spelunker.
Yeah, I hate that game.
Yeah, it doesn't fare too well on iOS with touch controls either.
See, I think the music in it's kind of cool, catchy, but other than that, there's actually an arcade version of it too that was only released in Japan.
Huh.
By Irem.
Huh. Yeah, I'd say double jump to the, oh wait, do you die if you hit the fans?
No.
Well, double jump to the middle platform. Oi! Woo!
This next level, I'm just staring at it, because I just can't. I'm just sitting here and just doing nothing. I can't even think of where to start, other than that switch, which seems to do jack diddly crap.